before we hook up the harness, I'm gonna test it out one more time just to make sure it works. And it is, so we're good to go. To do the to wire up the harness, we're gonna need two of these speed controllers, I guess that's what they call them. These are 250 watt, 20 volts, 24 volts, I'm sorry. So we're gonna be using two of these 12 volt batteries. Right now we're just gonna use one on each side to test, but what we're gonna do is gonna have two, we're gonna be using two batteries per motor. Here I have the hand throttle, the controller. Controls how fast and slow I can go with the cart. And I just wired it to the handle. And then the connection down here is gonna connect to the two speed controllers. So red right here is the positive, black is the negative, and then the white is the signal. It's gonna send a signal to the speed controllers. All right, and then you're actually gonna have to do a split. So each line is gonna have to split. I'm not sure if we have to split the power or just the signal, maybe just the signal. I'm not sure, I never wired this up before. So maybe I'll wire power to just one of these speed controller units, and then I will split the signal to both of them and see if that helps or works. It should work, I think. Yeah. And then I'll show you guys a little bit more this speed controller with all these wires here. There's a lot of wires that we won't need. I'm not any kind of pro at this. As a matter of fact, I'm just a beginner. This is my first time wiring it up, but I watched some of the YouTube videos and it was pretty clear after that. And I'll explain a little bit more of how this is gonna get wired up. So this is the speed controller that I got on Amazon. And at first it was kind of intimidating just to see all these wires and stuff. But after watching a few YouTube videos, it was pretty easy to understand. So you got the red and black, which is the power. You got the white and blue. This goes to the motor. And for the hand throttle, there's a three wire here. And then if you look on the speed controller itself, there's only one that has three wires to it. So you would match the red to red, black to black on the throttle control. And then this blue, it could come in any color, will go to the signal of the white on the throttle control. And then the rest, this is kind of tricky. There's four pairs left. And one of these is actually a kill switch. And if you don't have them connected, it's not gonna work. So that was the tricky part for me to figure out. I didn't know which one it was, so I made a little jumper like this. So after I have everything hooked up, I just put it in here like that. And then I tested it. This wasn't it. This blue one wasn't it. This other one wasn't it. But it was this one here that had to be connected like this. So you got power going into it. This one, I already put them all, both together. So, yeah. Okay, so now we're gonna put all the wires together. This here is to the motor. So I just made a little jumper. Connect that and that. As far as the motor goes, if you have the polarity going one way and the motor it's turning in one direction and you want to reverse it to the other direction, all you have to do is switch the polarity, and that's gonna drive the motor the other way, the opposite way. So you guys can kind of play around with that depending on how you mount this and which way you need it to spin. All you have to do is make the adjustment right here. All right, so this is the motor, and it's going in into I have it labeled red is the blue. So
Just gonna go ahead and go like that. All right, so we got the motor wire going to the motor wire. We're gonna connect the throttle control to this three wire set here. I'm gonna put something underneath here so you guys can see a little bit better. Okay, so this is throttle control. And this is the three wire on the speed controller. And I don't have a way to actually put a little connector and connect it to here. So I actually gotta cut this off. Like that. Put this back. You could hand twist them together and then use some electrical tape and tape them together. But I have these little waterproof. These are used for telephones. But once you squeeze them, they actually lock and seal so it doesn't get wet. So we're gonna go ahead and, I'm gonna go ahead and use that. So it's pretty important to note here that the second speed controller does needs to get wired into the first speed controller and to the throttle. So you will have a total of three black wires, three red wires. Just watch the last part where I connect all the signal wires together in a three-way.
All right. And red to red.
So I got the black to black and the red to the red. Now the signal one, I'm gonna connect it to the blue, but I'm also gonna connect it to the blue on the other controller as well, to this one as well. So it's gonna be a three-way split. Okay, so we got signal to the signal going into this first controller. And then I made a little jumper for the second controller. So it's gonna sit a little bit away from this first controller, so I have to make this long, a little bit longer jumper. And here, I'm gonna use this three-way connector. Now, if you don't have these available, you can use these dolphin clip, whatever works. Maybe you can even hand twist them and use some electrical tape. But I have these available, so I'm gonna use them here. And it's a little tricky to put on. And it doesn't have to be in any order. Just as long as they get in there. Like that. All right, and then pinch them together. Okay, and now you got this. Signal to signal to signal. So now let's connect the power to it. Okay, and then because this is a 24 volt speed controller, this has to be 24 volts. So you have to have, if you're gonna have a 12 volt battery, you're gonna have to wire them in series, okay? So, positive and negative here. So pretty much all wired up. This is the throttle. You see, if I press it, it doesn't move. That's because we forgot the little jumper. So let's go ahead and disconnect that. Put in the jumper. And then reconnect it. Now the throttle should work. See? Without that little jumper, that's what's gonna trip you up. You don't have that little jumper, it's not gonna work. All right, so that's how we wire it up. Now to tie in to the other side as well. Okay guys, it's all wired up. So throttle, go. Yay, see? Stop. Go slow. Fast. All right. And so now it's time to put everything together, but I'm gonna give you a recap really quick. One more time. Here we are. Red and black to power. Blue and white to motor. And then there's a whole bunch of other stuff that you won't need, so I just zip tie them together. The three wire is for the control, the throttle control. And what I basically did was I just tied it to the other speed controller. So I just tie them together. And then lastly is this, I guess, I don't know what it is, on and off switch, I guess. I just beam them together. So I'm not gonna be using a on and off switch. So, but if I do decide to in the future, I can go ahead and undo it and put on a switch. But for now, I just beam them together like that. All right. So yeah, and looks good. Good to go now. And now it's time to put everything together. I'm gonna put some extra stuff too. So extra framing, all of that stuff, but yeah, all the wiring's done and we're good to go. Ready?
Yeah.
Here we go. I can slow down so you can catch up. We could go walking pace.
Mm-hmm. Can we go faster?
Go faster?